Good afternoon, Your Majesties. Good morning slash afternoon. It's like 11. It's 11:15 or something. So good morning slash afternoon. Happy day 21 of Vlogmas. I cannot believe it's already December 21st. That's crazy. So I do have a few story times for you guys. The first one is that when I was a little teeny tiny baby, I had my hand surgery. I think that was when I had my first hand surgery. And apparently, I'm allergic to it, or my mom's allergic to it. So, anesthesia. I had anesthesia, and I think me and Mom Magister are both allergic to it because when my parents were driving home, and my dad was driving home, my mom was holding me in the front seat, and like I guess she was breathing in my anesthesia that I guess she was breathing it in, and she goes, "Babe, I pull over," and she got so sick. So yeah, we're both allergic to anesthesia. And the next story is that I had an anesthesia seizure when I was a baby. When I was little. I might have been a little bit older, but not that much older. My parents told me the story. My parents were like they saw like all these nurses and doctors around the bed, like making sure, like trying to like fix me. And my dad said that, "Oh my God, I hate to be that parent." And it was me that they were looking at. It was me that they were looking at. And so my dad was like, "What the heck is going on?" So, yeah, so that was that story. And I have one more. This is the story time when I was rambunctious, when I was in third grade. I remember my teacher at, well, no, I'm probably not gonna say the school or her name due to privacy reasons. But when I was in third grade, I remember I had a note sent home with me because I used the bird to someone. I flipped someone off. And it was in an envelope. And I remember it was a Friday. And so I just remember I threw it away. And the next day, when my dad was emptying the trash out, like pulling out the trash, the note was literally like on the. It was like it wasn't like right there, but like he would have to like dig just a little just to get it. But like when he was tying the bag, I saw the note and I'm like, "Oh my gosh, I cannot believe I'm not getting caught for this. This is crazy." And so I never got caught for it. My teacher never asked, like, "Hey Peyton, did you give, your parents that note that I sent home with you? Did you give, did your parents ever get the note?" I never once did my teacher ask me that, and I didn't feel guilty. I was actually happy I got away with it because I didn't want to be punished. But I did end up admitting it years later. I think like in 2015 or 16, I told my dad, I go, "Dad, I have something to tell you," and he goes, "Okay," and I go, "A long time ago, when I was in third grade, I was sent home with a note because I flipped someone off and I threw it away. And when I saw you taking the trash out, I saw like the envelope was right there, and kind of like in the middle of the trash bag. And so, and I never told you that." And he goes, "Okay, so what are you asking for? Forgiveness?" And I go, "Yes, I'm sorry." And he goes, "Okay, you've been forgiven." So yeah, that was another rambunctious thing I did when I was little. But yeah, I can't believe I didn't get caught. I'm surprised my teacher didn't call my parents asking, like, "Hey, did you get the note?" Or, so yeah. And I have another story time for you guys. So 7 years ago, we watched this movie called Moonrise Kingdom. Now, I don't know if you guys have seen it or have heard of it, so I won't give too many spoilers. I won't. I only remember this one part because it really stuck out to me, and it really bothered me too. So apparently, they were like at war. You know, like the boy character and the girl character. They were like at war with another camp, a campground thing, and so apparently the girl, bow and shot an arrow in the guy's stomach, and so he had to go to the infirmary and get stitches, and then afterwards, it shows the guy like standing by his tent with like I think it was the infirmary, like standing by the infirmary, and the guy was like, "Why would you hit me?" like or something like that, and like he said something, and then all of a sudden the guy comes and he just punches the guy right in his stitches area, and he screamed really loud. It was like a ow type of thing. Now, I would never watch that movie again because that really stuck with me. I can't get over it. But I don't know what bothered me the most, the fact that he hit the guy in his stitches area or the screaming part. I think it was both, but I just remember I was affected by that for a long time, And I know the saying, like, comes with great knowledge, comes with great responsibilities, is that once you see something, you can't get it out of your brain. And when I saw that, I have not been able to get it out of my head ever since I saw it. And this was like 7 years ago. It was like a few days after Thanksgiving, after we had just gotten back from Vegas. So yeah, and I just remember I started crying. I go, why couldn't he couldn't just punch him in the face? Like, not that I just think it'd be less intense than hitting someone in their surgery area. I just thought it would be a lot less brutal to be punched in the face than having someone punch you in your surgery area. And I just remember being so scared, and I remember asking my dad, I go, Dad, is it still gonna bother me tomorrow morning? And he goes, no. And yeah, it did stick with me. Like, I wasn't as scared, but I was uneasy about it. I felt very uneasy. So anywho, that's gonna be it for today's video. So if you're new here, hi, I'm Princess Peyton. Hit the red button to become your majesty and hit the bell notification so you're notified every time I upload a video. And I love you guys so much. You guys are the best human beings ever made. And you're the king of my heart and the song lyrics of Taylor Swift. And I will see you guys in tomorrow's video. Okay, love you. Bye. Mwah.